Get a good shot of the tandem here. And what I've done is taken the chain off. Before I fit the new one, I want to clean up the chain set. So I'm going to do that before I fit the new chain. And because it's such a filthy job, I'm going to wear some gloves. Suggested that to get the right length of chain, what I do is I put the old chain next to, lay the old chain out. You can see what a disgusting state these are in. Again, gloves on. This is the longer one, so this is the front chain. This has got 140 links on it. So he suggested I just lay it out and then put the new chain beside it. Measure it out. Now the new chain has only got 116 links on this one, so what I'm going to have to do is join two of them together. So let's get the new one out. And this comes with one of these sort of easy link things, so hopefully it should be easy to join two together. Make one long chain. Let's put that to one side. Again, this one's a greasy as well. Luckily, the rear chain is shorter on the tandem. So, as we can see, this one is only 116 links, and the one that I'm replacing is 140. So, what I'm going to do is I'm going to put two of them together. Now, here's the trick. It's joining them together. I don't think it's going to be easy. And then when I put them on the tandem, to put the front chain on first. Yeah, it looks like, as you can see, that there's... No, actually, I'm going to be putting the back chain on first. Anyway, let's measure them up, get them both the right length, and then I can go and put them on. Right, here we go. So what I want to do here is I want to join them together with this extra link that they give you, which in theory, according to the instructions, just clicks into place. Let's have a look. So I can fix it on one side now. It says that you have to do it in this sort of horseshoe shape. So let's put that on there. Then that goes next to there. And then the two should just click together. You can see the sort of sliding. That goes in there, that goes in there, and then you just pull them apart. well, in the diagram, it's just got a nice little pull and a click. Good. There we go. That's in place. Now when I go to put that on the bike, I have to make sure that that's facing in the right direction. So now, what I'm going to do is make sure that this chain is the same length as the one that I've just taken off. Unfortunately, I don't have a table. That's 40 links long. This old chain has got 140 links in it, and the new one, well, I've just joined together two chains that are 116 each. So let's just count those up to where I want to. So this interesting little tool is to remove the chain links. So what I do is I put it in there next to the link that I want to remove. So let's just make sure that's nice and tight in there. Let's tighten that up so it's nice and straight. Yep, and then what I do is I tighten this. Very specific little tool, this one. What I want to do is to push out that rivet that's in there. Push that through, and then once that's done, take that back out, and I can feel it loosen up, and we should have and then that rivet that I've just removed, which has bounced back out of there, I'll keep it, although I shouldn't use it again because I've got this nice little clicky tool now that I can use. Right, so that chain now should be equal in length to the one that I took off, and what I'm going to do is measure up the other one and then fit them both. So put that to one side, get the other one. Now this one should be about the right length because the one that I've taken off is actually shorter than the new one. So with any luck, I shouldn't need to do too much work on this one. I'm not going to be adding two together. So let's get those out of the way. Now this is the leftover chain from the last one, which I don't think is going to be long enough, is it? No. So what I'll do is I'll keep that as a spare. And let's open up a new one. So these are just your bog standard 5-7 speed bicycle chain, probably the cheapest and most basic one you can get in Halfords. They do different ones for different types of bikes. Some have much larger links between them. You can get ones for single speed, for BMXs. These are just your sort of standard road bike chain. Quite a reasonable price. So I've got three of them so that I could join two together, and then as you can see, this one's just slightly too long, so I'm going to do what I did with the last one and take some links out. but I think what I'm going to do is I'm not going to take any links out until I've actually measured it up on the tandem itself, and then I'll be able to see what I need to do. So let's fit it on the tandem. Now, some very nice chaps on YouTube have done videos on how to fit a chain. So the hardest part is fitting it through the derailleur at the back. So I think what I'll do is I'll put it over first. Now, because this a tandem has got two chain sets, you end up having to, you can see on the central chain set you have two chains going through it. So the back one has drape that across. So the back one, it's the inside cog that goes round here, and I'm going to fit it on the lowest of the gears, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 gears. I'm going to fit it on the lowest one there so that it's as loose as it'll go. And then what I'm going to do is feed that through the derailleur, and you can see the direction it goes in because of the shape of the cog here. Oh, it's a fiddly job, there we go. And you can see that the shape of it, it's like a sort of half moon, goes through there, over there. You've got the two cogs there, you see, those are going through, and what will happen is when that's nice and tight, oh, I've loosened it again, haven't I? Right, when that's nice and tight, it will fit snugly around there and then come together at the bottom. Now what I want is to make sure that on the highest gear, right, that's on the lowest gear at the moment, that's going to come round there. It's all going to fit together very nicely, come round there. Now I've got to make sure that the chain isn't so tight that you can't change gears on it. So as far as I can tell, that's nice and snug. That's about right, actually. Because if I pull the derailleur around, the derailleur around, actually what it's going to do is it's going to go across there. This is not a one man job, one woman job. I need two pairs of hands on this. This spring on it is trying to pull back against me, so if I hold that in place, the thread, the chain through there. Oh. Right, that's straight, yes. Thread the chain through there. Round that cog, come on, round there, fit in, is it fitted in? Yes, lovely and snug, pull that through just a little bit more, nice and snug. Now that, when I pull it down, yes, that's more like it. There, those two join together there, and that is perfect fit. So let's let go of that. This one is far more simple. just a case of draping it around the cog on the back wheel. In some ways, I think not having much experience of bike maintenance is an advantage with this Tandem, because you can tell that there are some really weird little quirks. Now, like this thing for a start, which I'm inclined to take off. I've noticed none of the modern Tandems have them, and I'm not absolutely sure why it's there. It's a bit of a pain, because when you're riding, it flips up and it catches on the chain. Okay, so let's bring that round. I don't want to pull the back chain set, because it's still got the other chain sitting on it. So let's make sure that I've got plenty of slack in that. And there. Bring that around to make sure that all fits nicely. And then here's the front chain. Make sure that's sitting in the teeth there. That's sitting nicely in there. And then make sure actually that's slightly too long. Which is what I suspect this thing is for. Just to keep it taut. Right. What I want to do is falling off again. And then hold that in place whilst I fix that together. Pop that in there. No, that's not it. So let's push that back out again. Oh, typical, isn't it? When I don't want it to go in so easily, it's gone in. Right, let's get that back out again. He's driving out the wall, these gloves. Get rid of it. I'm just going to have to get my hands dirty. That goes in there, thank you. That goes in there. Come on. Right. Now they're both in, they should both pull apart. There is a lot of slack in that. I'm not sure about that at all. I think what I might do is feed it through this. See if that does help. Right, so that's that one done. Just enough slack on that. Right, so again, have to make sure it's the right shape. It goes towards the middle. Goes, is that right? Like that. That one goes like that. Two of them fit in. And then pull apart. Now this one's going to be a bit harder. There we go. Right. Both chains are now in place. You're going to turn for me? Oh yeah, that front one's falling off already. Okay, let's see. There we have it. Let's turn her around.